That, oh, on the replays?
Yeah.
I am official. What you talking about? Talking about Willis? Good afternoon, hockey fans. Game 2 on the day, Saturday, December 4th. The Eli Johnson Memorial Tournament here in Moorhead. Playing on the Bushy Rink this afternoon. Moorhead squaring off against an equally competitive team from Elk River. We're expecting a close one today based on what we've been watching on this Elk River team. They definitely came to play, and they've been playing similar teams than what our boys and girl have been playing up against, with similar results as far as scoring. Should be exciting. Some things that Moorhead's gonna have to watch out for and be careful of is protecting in front of the net, making sure that we reduce the number of scoring chances on rebounds that are being offered up without having coverage from our defense or supporting forwards, tying up any loose ends that find themselves standing in the house. That being the area immediately in front of the net down in our own defensive zone, pretty much from the blue painted area along the goal line up to the hashies, the hash marks on either side of the circles on the face-off dots. So we're gonna have to protect the net in that area. Make sure that we don't offer up any garbage goals while at the same time taking advantage of that same exact situation in the offensive end, making sure that we're crashing the net on every drive, picking up and trying to capitalize on any loose ends that may present itself. Either way, I think we're going to be up for a good game here this afternoon. Should be exciting. Thanks everybody for logging in. Appreciate it. Just under 2 minutes of warmies left, and then we'll be putting the pucks all back up into the buckets and then getting this game underway. For a brief minute here and make a video adjustment to try and get better clarity so that I don't have any interference with spectators. So video will stop here briefly and I'll be right back. All All right, now we're back. Apologize for that brief interruption. Here we are, about to get underway. Taking off the initial draw for Moorhead, number three, Landing Gerskis. He's paired up this afternoon with line mates Brody Elliott at left wing and Caleb Schockert at right wing. Anna Herman, lefty, the puck carrier there, and her defensive line mates, number five, Cole Salvavold. Herman now dumping the puck up to Brody Elliott up in the neutral zone. Elliott charging forward. Nice little 3-on-1 opportunity for Moorhead there. Schockert with a shot opportunity sends the puck wide of the Elk River net. Anna Herman doing a fantastic job of keeping the puck in control and in possession just inside the neutral zone. Brody Elliott now, he tries it. He hits the top post there. Top corners almost sent the puck in for Elliott. Rebound attempt there by Landon Gerskis. Right into the glove of the Elk River goaltender. He's going to hang on to it and get a stoppage play. Nice save there by the goaltender reacting to that puck that otherwise would have been going in for Gerskis. Faceoff win for Reese Oswald. Kept in the zone there by Bodie Ferry and dumped. Attempted to be dumped down into the zone by number two, Ethan Bjorkman. Puck carrier now picked up by Reese Oswald. He'll carry the puck into the corner. He has the puck stripped off by the Elk River player. Recovered there by Oswald. Nice centering pass. Intended target was number 14, Wyatt Olson. He's tied up on the play, and Elk River changes direction and brings the puck down into the Moorhead zone. Taken down on the play there, Elk River player by Bodie Ferry. Puck recovered by Elk River. That shot hits the post, far post. That was a blind shot. That was a fantastic play there by Elk River. Nice save there by Dylan Elliott. Just getting enough of a glove on it. Kept the puck. That puck was going in, folks. Elliott just coming in clutch for the boys on that. That was a fantastic save. Reese Oswald, now the puck carrier, coming out from behind the Moorhead net. He's going to come skating down. He's going to dump the puck along the boards. He's going to send it all the way down. Allow the referees to blow the whistle and bring us an icing call. Elk River coming in hot already from the start, showing that they're perfectly capable of getting dangerous pucks right in front of our own net and getting shots off. Moorhead's going to have to step up their game back in our defensive zone, make sure that we reduce those numbers of plays. Faceoff there against Mason Mohelski. Possession won by Elk River, dumped behind the Moorhead net. Recovered now by Mason Mohelski. He dumps it along the boards where it's picked up by Grady Mickelson. He gets taken off the play by that Elk River defender who charged forward. Loose puck now, bouncing up. Mickey coming out of the zone. That Elk River player sent a lunar of a shot right over the net, up above Elliott's head. Puck finally even finds its way here out into the neutral area. Brady Mickelson trying to figure out how to create some time and space. He gets the puck checked off of his stick. Battle right in front along near side boards, won by Elk River as they come back down into the Moorhead zone. Centering pass attempt picked off nicely by Anna Herman, number 13 from Moorhead. She dumps the puck along the boards. Brady Mickelson reaching for the puck, trying to tip it past that defender. Loose puck now picked up by Anna Herman. She dumps it up to Brady Mickelson. Mickelson trying to blindly pass the puck out center. Has it picked off by the Elk River defender. Elk River come charging in. Wide angle shot from the bottom of the circle there, saved by Dylan Elliott. Recovered and dumped out of the zone by Moorhead. Moorhead looking like they're doing more chasing than they are being the aggressor now. Elk River coming in. That shot goes just wide of the net. Dylan Elliott, netminder, watched that one soar past to his right-hand side of his blocker. Mason Mihalski now passing the puck up to Weston Olson. Weston Olson carries it across the blue line. While Brady Mickelson was already in the zone, that's going to be an offsides for Moorhead and brings us a line change. Landon Gerskis out taking the draw now. Moorhead, Gerskis wins the draw right to the stick of Brody Elliott. Elliott dumps the puck down into the Elk River zone. Picked up by Elk River and they dumped it along. Out at the blue line, was picked up by Bjorkman. He's trying to whiff on his shot. Loose puck there by Elliott, picked up by Gerskis. He tried putting it up over the goalie who was down on the ice, sends the puck high up over the net. Recovered now in the corner by Caleb Schockert. He recovered it, but that centering pass is picked off by Elk River. Now they're charging forward. Brody Elliott coming in from behind. Fantastic back check and a leg save there by brother Dylan Elliott, the tendy from Moorhead. Knocks the puck wide. That shot on net interrupted prior to hitting the net by Bodie Ferry. That was puck along the boards. Ethan Bjorkman now chasing the puck. He tried beating the puck into the Elk River zone. Wasn't able to get to the puck prior to Elk River getting there. Bodie Ferry, now the puck carrier, dumps it across to Reese Oswald. He's going to change directions. Oswald turning right on the inside of the net. He's going to continue carrying the puck now out into the neutral zone. Oswald still carrying the puck for Moorhead. Has the puck tipped off of his stick by that Elk River defensive player. And now Elk River's going to change direction and bring it back down towards Moorhead. Loose puck now picked up by Cole Salvevold. Salvevold still holding the puck, sticking it, trying to figure out what to do. Dumps puck along the boards. Picks up his own pass. He's going to try and do the same thing. Allows the puck to get down into the Elk River zone. Had Caleb Schockert on the other side of the blue line, though, rather. And so we're going to get another offsides call. Another stoppage of play. A lot of back and forth. Both teams showing that they're fairly capable of carrying the puck down ice. They're kind of come down to whoever wants this more, whoever's going to be working hard. Puck finds its way, getting past the Moorhead defense now. Anna Herman giving chase down in the near side corner. She wraps it around behind the Moorhead net, where Wyatt Olson, number 14 for Moorhead, is waiting. He gets the puck lifted off of his stick. Reese Oswald now coming in for Moorhead. Oswald just out of reach. Had the puck extend right off of his stick. Couple players there trying to get shots. Wyatt Olson tried reaching that puck, and it just reeked right past the very tip of his blade, unable to get anything on it. Cole Salvable now charging into the zone. He gets a shot that goes wide of the net. Elk River now does their fair share of dumping on the puck. That puck had a lot of breaks, and a very fast Elk River player who is chasing down now on Cole Salvable. Lots of slashing. Penalty is going to be called now on Elk River for all of those slashing. As Cole Salvable, or it's going to be a hooking call rather, not slashing. When Cole Salvable was skating with that, and that Elk River player was got his stick a little bit too high and kept it there, impeding the forward progress of Cole Salvable. It's going to give Moorhead their first power play of the game. Gives them a 5-on-4 one-man advantage opportunity against Elk River, and that brings the play, or the faceoff rather, back down here in the Elk River zone due to the penalty. Some confusion on some part in the box with the referee. A minute and a half is the penalties for this tournament. There has been some confusion on that, as it was stated in a tournament booklet that part of the rules is that penalties would be 2 minutes, but due to Minnesota youth hockey regulations, 15-minute periods with minute and a half penalties is what we have to go with. So that's what we're following, regardless of whatever it would say in an outdated tournament rulebook. Elk River now gaining possession of the puck, carries it down into the Moorhead zone. Penalty going to be called now on Ethan Bjorkman as he got a little bit too high and put his shoulder into that Elk River player and sends him up onto his back as he crashed him into the boards. It's going to bring even play back now as both teams are going to be playing 4-on-4. At least for the next minute and 5 seconds until the initial Elk River penalty expires. Faceoff there, won by Elk River, recovered by Brody Elliott as he charges forward and carries the puck down deep into the Elk River zone. Loose puck finds its way behind the Elk River net. Gerskis now giving chase on that. Elliott trying everything he can to keep it in. Elk River able to sneak the puck past that blue line. Recovered by Elliott, who dumps the puck across. Cole Salvo now grabs the puck, dumps it down, wraps it around behind the Elk River net. Recovered by Elk River in the far corner. He does a backhand blind pass. Picked up now by one of his teammates. Recovered by a stick. Kept in the zone by Anna Herman. Originally dumped it right into the skates of the Elk River player. Herman gets tied up with an additional Elk River player, and they're going to come charging forward. Pet's shot attempt goes just wide of the net and dumped now down in the corner by an Elk River player. Brody Elliott, loose puck, unaware of where it was right in front. Shot from out point, recovered now by Dylan Elliott as he had to jump around multiple players in front of the net. Saw that thing coming and Superman dove to get that thing caught on his glove prior to it going into the net. Excellent job by Dylan Elliott on that save. He's going to take time to exit out of the crease and cool his head off on that, knowing that he just had a job well done on that play. Getting a nice little leg tap from his teammates, like to see that. Faceoff won by Reese Oswald, dumped across to Bodie Elliott. That shot goes right into the shin pads of Bodie Ferry, rather, not Bodie Elliott. Ferry getting tied up on the play, loses possession of the puck. Covered by Reese Oswald. Oswald now backhand dumps it back across. Ferry tried centering pass to Caleb Schuckert. He loses the puck right in front of the net as he was two-manned on by multiple different Elk River players, and that puck goes flying wide across the other side of the ice and ricochets off. Recovered by Reese Oswald. The intended target was Bodie Ferry. Looks like he blew a tire on that and laid down, face down, trying to reach for the puck. Luckily for Moorhead, though, Elk River finds themselves in an offsides position. Brings a stoppage of play as they otherwise no doubt would have been driving straight in towards the net. Oswald winning the faceoff from Moorhead right over to Donovan Lewin, picked up by Ferry. Ferry backhands the puck high up into the right into the chest pad of an Elk River player that keeps it down into the Moorhead zone. Recovered by Brady Mickelson in the corner. He loses an edge. Reese Oswald now battling for the puck, unable to get it out of the zone. Kept into the zone quite fantastically there by... Oh my goodness! Interesting round of events there. The centering pass was knocked wide by Bodie Ferry, where there was an initial shot on net by Elk River, and then there was a wide open rebound that somehow didn't go in a completely wide open net from within about 5 feet in front. The puck goes just wide of the net. Moorhead snuck away and got extremely lucky on that one. Elk River, unfortunately, not so lucky. And now Moorhead trying to do the same thing there. Centering shot on net from behind the goal line, recovered down in the corner by number 14, Wyatt Olson. His shot pops the puck straight out front. Reese Oswald, number 10, was there trying to get a rebound attempt. And then also number 7, Donovan Lewin, comes charging in, trying to get these loose pucks that I was talking about prior to the game, seeing if they can capitalize on any rebounds. Nice save there and recovery by the Elk River goalie. Faceoff now won by Landon Gerskis across to number 6, Brody Elliott. He's going to come out with the puck with multiple red jerseys strapped around him. Elk River now dumping the puck out of the zone. That player's got lots of wheels. He was launching down ice. He had rockets behind his knees. He's going to dump the puck out to their D-men. They go across D. Shot gets ricocheted wide by the Moorhead defense prior to reaching Elliott. Another puck goes dumped wide. That shot goes just wide of the net. Anna Herman now giving chase. Puck now intended for Elk River defense. Picked off by That was Brody Elliott, and he sent the puck up to number 8, Caleb Schockert. Schockert now having his own battle, trying to win the puck. That puck finds its way to the Elk River defense, where it's dumped out in the neutral zone. Cole Salvo fumbled on the puck a little bit. Huge centering pass there. Apologies if it was my video was out of view. Centering pass there to a wide-open Elk River player. Thankfully for Moorhead, the Elk River player wasn't able to connect with that puck, as he would have had just a point-blank shot. Nobody anywhere near him for Moorhead. Again, Moorhead getting lucky on that. Loose puck now, covered by Caleb Schockert. Tired, as soon as he got across the red line, he dumped the puck down so that Moore could get all new, fresh legs out, and that's exactly what they do. Moorhead now charging down into the Elk River zone. Kept in the zone there nicely by Mickey. It's going to send Weston Olson chasing behind the net. He's going to continue on into the corner. Mickey coming from the far side. That puck finds its way out now. Ethan Bjorkman, number 2, he's going to take some time to go back, regroup. He's going to switcheroo and send it along the boards and dump it all the way down. And that's going to be an icing call, as there was no interference with anybody's stick prior to it reaching the other side of the goal line. Lots of action so far in the first period. Still tied at zeros. 5 minutes and 42 seconds remain in this first period in the game here between Moorhead Squirt A Blue and Elk River. Faceoff won by Elk River against Moorhead, recovered there by Mickey as the puck found its way out into the defense. Bodie Ferry now the puck carrier. He's going to carry it down in the far corner. He's going to try and backhand as he lost his footing on the play. Weston Olson now giving chase, trying to knock the puck off that stick. Unable to keep control of it was Elk River. Into the stick of Ethan Bjorkman. He gets tied up on the play, unable to get the puck back. Another puck that found its way out to the Elk River defense. He puts the puck on net, and it's going to be stopped by Dylan Elliott as he laid his stick down flat and quickly covers it with his glove to get a freezing ice call. Definitely a grinder between these two teams so far. It's going to come down to, eventually, which team wants it more. That pass up front, just out of the reach of Reese Oswald. Now it's going to bring Elk River coming back. They're going to try their attempt. That shot just goes wide and hits the netting on the side of the net. Centering pass there from behind, quickly covered up and blocked by Dylan Elliott as he wrapped his pad up correctly up into the post, not allowing anything to sneak between his skate in the inside pipe. Brings another whistle on the play. Elk River sending out a new line. Moorhead having just done a line change. They're going to leave that group of players out. Oswald now taking the draw for Moorhead. He wins the draw. Bounces off the stick of Cole Salvavold. That shot, centering pass. Unfortunately, it was trying to get cleared by Anna Herman, and which redirected the puck right to the right-hand side of Dylan Elliott, who had dropped down to save that. It's an unfortunate change of direction. Herman finding herself in the same type of situation that previously this morning Reese Oswald found himself in, with a puck ricocheting off of his skate. Not much you can do on that. Herman, no doubt, putting it a pretty heavy amount of guilt on herself on that. She'll be receiving lots of praise from her teammates, saying don't worry about it. Bodies flying everywhere now in front of the Moorhead net as Elk River recovers the puck. Their centering pass gets broken up on the play by multiple Moorhead players, and now Ethan Bjorkman's going to carry the puck out. That puck ricochets off an Elk River player right to the stick of Brody Elliott. Elliott's going to carry the puck down. His backhand centering pass bouncing right over the stick of Caleb Schockert, who was teed up, ready to send that one firing into the back of the net. Elk River now coming in. Big, huge windup from that Elk River player, sends the puck just wide of the net. You can hear the boom as it hit the backboards. That could have a little bit of a rifle shot. They'll have to watch out for that. Centering pass now recovered by Elk River. They've got some speed on a couple of these players. Lots of unguarded people now. That shot goes just wide of the net, reaches behind the net covered by Dylan Elliott. Moorhead now losing a couple of shots. That Elk River player tried walking in front. Bodie Ferry gets the puck stripped off there by couple of Elk River players. Cleared wide of the net now by Landon Gerskis to the stick of Brody Elliott. There you saw Caleb Schockert. He was trying to skate up on the puck, had the puck slapped off by Elk River, and now Elk River once again is going to be getting possession of the puck, chasing down into Moorhead zone. Brody Elliott now gets pushed up along the boards. Recovered behind the net now by Bodie Ferry. He flips the puck up along the boards, and now Caleb Schockert's going to come racing down, trying to do what he can. He gets the puck stripped off of that Elk River player. Family members of the Elk River players unhappy about that right in front of me. Another shot by Caleb Schockert goes just wide of the net from right out front. Anna Herman now coming into the neutral zone. It's going to be recovered by Elk River after Anna Herman dumped it down in. Mason Mahelski now charging down into the Elk River zone. He gets tied up along the boards and shoved down onto the ice by an Elk River player. Little fumble of a pass there by an Elk River player trying to guard it. We've got Elk River charging forward. Anna Herman now is going to be coming in. She knocks the player off of his skates and comes out with the puck. She's going to skate behind Moorhead's bench. Herman now charging forward, has all the speed. Herman now going to be coming in all on her own, goes around everybody, sends a whistler right past the side of the net, picked up along the inside boards here right in front of the camera by Cole Selvold. He dumps it back down into the corner. Elk River player looking like he was trying to ride a canoe, had the puck between his legs, recovered now out in the neutral area by Cole Selvold, who dumps it along the boards. Picked up now by Mason Mahelski, who tips it up to Brady Mickelson. Mickelson still regains possession. He has the puck knocked off of his stick. Mickelson trying to reach the puck out to defense. Diving forward there was Cole Selvold to keep it into the zone. Covered along the far boards by Reese Oswald. Elk River coming in, doing what they can to get it centered out. Mickey somehow keeping that puck in the Elk River zone. Finally gets knocked off of his skates as Elk River comes charging down forward now. Reese Oswald coming in to give his spark. He puts on the brakes. He's going to wind up and send the puck up, only to have it caught through the air by Elk River. Another puck that got ricocheted, almost went inside the pipes on that as it was changed direction. Luckily for Moorhead, just on about within 6 inches from hitting the pipe. Another close one that was a redirect. Cole Salvable doing a fine job of poking the puck off of that player's stick. Carried out now and tipped up by Brady Mickelson. He passes it up to Reese Oswald. Puck going just a little bit too fast for Oswald to stay with it. Herman now, being the unstoppable force that she is, she comes in and stops that play dead in its tracks. Passes it across to Salvi, who passes it up to Reese, who tried hitting Mickelson. Huge collision there, center ice. It's going to give a penalty now on Mason Mahelski. They're going to call him for checking as he came in and took that Elk River player out as they were both kind of heading for the puck. It's going to put Moorhead on another penalty kill. 44 seconds left in this game. Or 44 seconds left in the first period, rather, not the game. Faceoff won by Moorhead, picked up in the near corner by Ethan Gorkman. He dumps it along the boards and follows through. He chases after his own puck. Picked up there now and held into that corner by Elk River. Trying to get puck slapped away multiple times by a couple players. Now Bodie Ferry finally gets control of the puck, and he's going to come charging out and bring it out in at least into the neutral zone. Ferry still continuing burning hoof down the ice. He gets the puck stripped off of his stick. Brady Mickelson picks it up and dumps it back to Reese Oswald. Oswald now taking an eye to see what's going on. Mickelson doing a nice little stick move. He's going to continue with the puck and carry it down into the Elk River zone. Mickelson now, he gets tied up, multiple players on the play. Still battling and raging on. He's swatting at the puck, trying to get anything. And that's going to bring the end of the buzzer whistle. Fantastic game so far. Very even back and forth. Moorhead unfortunately falling, having that misdirect with that unintentional goal by Herman that popped it in right to the right-hand side of Dylan Elliott, gives Elk River this 1-0 lead above our Moorhead Squirt A blue team. After one, Moorhead still a man down. The Mason Mahelski penalty has got 46 seconds remaining on it. So Moorhead will start the second period with a 5-on-4 one-man disadvantage. Okay, with Schockert taking the draw for Moorhead to start off the second period. Possession control by Moorhead. Back to Herman, who passes it across to Salvi. Salvi's going to hit the stick of Caleb Schockert, trying to bring it down into the zone. He gets tied up on the play and loses it. Herman coming in from the side. Two Moorhead spuds, Schockert and Gerskis, crashing into each other here on the neutral area. Salvable without a stick. Gets a centering pass where there were two Elk River players wide open, and an easy redirect there, as there was nobody to guard them, with Salvo losing his stick and Herman having to go in and cover the puck carrier. Easy goal for Elk River that kept Dylan Elliott on the other half side of the net. That was a power play goal for Moorhead now, as there's still 23 seconds that would have been remaining on the Mohelski goal. So that penalty gets terminated now due to the goal, and Moorhead's back 5-on-5. Faceoff now in possession of Cole Salvo, who dumps it along the boards for a couple Moorhead players who were waiting for the puck, and Elk River recognized that, and they were the aggressor on that, charged forward and took that. Another penalty is going to be called now. A high sticking on Landon Gerskis. It's going to once again put Moorhead with the one man down at disadvantage here already. 41 seconds into the second period. Reese Oswald taking the draw. Ref quick to drop the puck there, even before Reese, I think, was ready. That shot goes wide of the net from the Elk River defense. Elk River dumping the puck out. Picked off out front now by Bodie Ferry. Ferry knocking the puck wide. Donovan Lewin coming in, grabbing the puck and sending it right to the stick of the Detroit Lakes, of the Elk River defense player. It allows them to get a shot towards the net that goes wide. Recovered now, carried behind the net by Ethan Bjorkman. He sends it up along the boards to Donovan Lewin. Donovan Lewin backhanding the puck right to the board so that he can grab it again right immediately by himself. Now he carries it and dumps it, tries dumping it down into the Elk River zone. Kept in the zone there by Reese Oswald. He gets the puck poked off of his stick. Charging forward was Ferry now. Oswald and Elk River player, they both go down on the play, and it's recovered by Elk River and dumped down into the Moorhead zone. Covered now by Ferry. He's going to come skating around Cirques. He sends it out in the middle of ice right to the stick of Elk River player. Intended target was Reese Oswald, I believe, on that. And Elk River dumps the puck now. Wraps it around the boards behind Moorhead's net. An entire line change for Elk River brings all of them with fresh legs. Moorhead still one man down, has got legs out there that are now getting tired as they've been out for this entire shift. Donovan Lewin doing what he can to reach for the puck and try and knock it off. He's going to try and battle for the puck. Right close down here, an intimate in front. Bodie Ferry also doing the same. Loose puck now, finally picked up by Reese Oswald. He tries carries it across. Big, huge collision there on the play as Elk River dove in. Lots of snow in front of the Elk River bench already. It's keeping the puck from moving forward. The puck, having lots of steam, immediately hits that snow pile in front of the door to the Elk River bench. Bodie Ferry loses track of the puck now as it's carried up and recovered now alongside of the net by Donovan Lewin, who's been out there for multiple minutes. He's going to have to try and get a line change at the earliest possible opportunity. Now that'll give him a chance to get off the ice as Dylan Elliott receives a pass that would have been going wide, knowing that his teammates needed a change. Used his stick to pop the puck up into his glove, and he's going to hold on to it and get that much-needed stop and play that Moorhead was requiring in order to get some fresh legs out there. Weston Olsen now trying to do something. He comes flipping backwards. I think he was trying to do a back somersault right there on the ice, get his teammates fired up, see if it does anything. Loose puck now picked up by Mickey, and he lost the edge of it, and so it found its way right to the Elk River player. Picked up now again by Mason Mihalski, and he's going to do what he can to charge it down into the Elk River zone. That puck hit the skates of Mickey. Shot from the point now by Cole Salvold. Mickey there getting a rebound. He gets pushed off of his skates by a player. I'm unsure on how that wasn't a penalty when we've been called on multiple things like that. Anna Herman now trying to skate around with the puck. Mickey, once again, sends the puck right to an Elk River player who was there waiting, intercepted that pass. Nice block on that shot by Anna Herman, right into the shin pads, and now Elk River sends the puck. Again, there's going to be a stoppage of play for too many men on the ice on Elk River. A big collision there along the boards in that far corner was Cole Salvevold. Moorhead now finally finding themselves in a spot of advantage, and we'll hopefully see if they can capitalize on this, having one man up, especially now with the penalty bringing the faceoff deep down in the Elk River zone. Brody Elliott taking the draw for Moorhead. Teed up with Landon Gerskis at right wing and Reese Oswald at left. Elliott battling for the puck, unable to move his stick. Finally, he gets around the referee's legs, sends the puck back to Ethan Bjorkman, who tries to wind up and take some resemblance of a slap shot. That goes wide of the net. Puck finds its way back to Bjorkman again. He sends it across to Bodie Ferry. Ferry tees up and hits the right into the legs of an Elk River player. Puck saved there by Brody Elliott. Bjorkman again coming in, sends a flutter puck flying through the air. Loose puck picked up by Gerskis. He's going to put on the brakes behind the Elk River net and dump it along the boards on the other side, where Bjorkman was able to get over there and send it back into the corner. Centering pass there by Gerskis, found the stick of Brody Elliott. Elliott unable to get a shot off, tried to hit Gerskis again, and that's going to allow Elk River to finally get possession of it, and they're going to send the puck all the way down. Icing's called off on the play, as it must have been tipped along the way. Pass there, not sure who the intended target would have been, by Bodie Ferry. Starting to look a little sloppy than what this Moorhead team looked like this morning. Playing against a team that definitely has challenged them more. They'll have to try and figure out how to get their wits back together. Shot there from the point on Elk River. Goes between the rudders of Dylan Elliott. Dylan, obviously and noticeably upset with himself, smacks the post with his stick as the puck was bouncing on the ice, and he was trying to drop down. Couldn't decide if he wanted to use his stick or not, and the puck found its way going between the leg pads. Teammates obviously going in, trying to tell him, you know, that it's all right, shake it off. We're still behind you. We're one unit. We're a team. We win as a team, and we lose as a team. Telling him to not worry about it, keep his head in the game. Letting them know that they're not upset with him. Faceoff now, won by Moorhead, picked up by Caleb Schockert. He gets the puck stripped off of his stick by an Elk River player. Recovered by Cole Salvo, who dumps it along the boards. Down into the Elk River zone. Mason Mohelski given chase, picked up there by Caleb Schockert. He tried dumping the puck down to Mohelski, who was tied up on the play. Recovered now by Schockert, centering pass to Weston Olson, who was tied up. I think the goaltender might have gotten his stick out to intercept. Moorhead now getting caught on a line change at Elk River, and they're able to capitalize on it as they was able to put enough on the stick and it's caught Dylan Elliott sliding into the save, and it sent it just inside the near side post to us, is giving Elk River an unfortunate 4-0 lead. And there's going to be a timeout now called by Moorhead, as the coaching staff on the bench was recognizing the frustration and kind of the flustered play that Moorhead is coming in. The two goaltenders now tapping gloves at center ice, doing what I had touched on yesterday. Goaltenders having a special connection among players, even when on opposite teams. It's something that you see in the NHL, where there's that mutual respect because they know the position they're in. They know what they each go through. And so they're the first ones that'll offer support to the other when they know that things necessarily aren't going your way. Moorhead now taking time to try and figure out how to regroup. Hopefully they can do exactly that. Get their heads back on their shoulders and start playing better, smarter hockey. Not worry about the score that it is and start playing hard so that they can come charging in. Referee now waiting for Elliott to get situated in the net. He does so, and so the puck drops. Resuming play in the second period here in Moorhead. Puck gets dumped now down into the Elk River zone, chased by Donovan Lewine, finds its way back out and in the neutral zone. That puck gets stripped off nicely by Anna Herman. She passes it up to Bodie Ferry, who don't know who he was trying to go for. He sent the puck right into the defense of Elk River. Loose puck there, tempted to get swatted in by Donovan Lewine. He lost an edge and went down on his knees in front of the Elk River net. Elk River charging forward once again after dumping the puck along the boards. Got her own Herman. Cole Salvo coming in, giving his support. He did a nice job of recovering that puck. Found the puck out to the defense of Elk River, and he tried going DDD. Wyatt Olson there charging forward. He lost his edge on that play, trying to reach that puck. Recovered now by Donovan Lewine, who's out there again. He's going to come chasing after the puck after he got shoved off along the boards and lost possession. Recovered now by Reese Oswald. Oswald trying to do what he can to get a backhand pass. He gets taken out on the play and unable to get anything of substantial strength on that shot. Recovered now by Elk River. Elk River taking time to figure out what they want to do. They're going to dump it down into the center ice where the puck was bouncing around and put on brakes. DDD pass there by Ethan Bjorkman. Sends it across to Brady Mickelson. Mickelson sends it up to Landon Gerskis. A penalty is going to be called now on Elk River for trip. Oh. Yeah, penalty being called now on Elk River. Landon Gerskis, thinking that the penalty was being called on him, started going to the penalty box, causing myself to pause, as that also confused me watching Gerskis do that, asking the ref me, and finally you could verbally hear the ref say, nope, him. So that cleared it up quite nicely. Faceoff there, one possession controlled by Moorhead, brought back to that was Brady Mickelson, passed it across to Bjorkman, who tried doing another slap shot, which flutter puck through the air with not a lot of substantial strength, went wide of the net. Centering pass there by Bjorkman, recovered, bouncing around by Brody Elliott. Come charging in there from out front, center front, was Reese Oswald. As Elk River regained possession and they tried charging down, recovered now in the neutral area by Brody Elliott. He dumps it up to Landon Gerskis, who's going to carry it down into the Elk River zone. Elk River shoving him up along the boards. Gerskis taking time to send the puck back to Ethan Bjorkman. He sends another winder up that goes just wide of the net. Elliott now, the puck carrier, has a nice centering pass to Landon Gerskis, who was able to get a shot off, but it was stopped by the defense. Brody Elliott now gets taken down on the play. It's going to put another penalty in for Elk River, as Elliott was taken down on that play. It's going to give Moorhead the rare advantage of having a 5-on-3 two-man advantage up against Elk River. If there's any time for Moorhead to pop one in and start getting the momentum going in their direction, right now is the moment for them to change the favor of this game. No better opportunity than having this many men advantage out there. Faceoff there, won by Caleb Scheckert. He sends the puck back to Cole Salvold. Salvold kind of whiffed on that pass. Recovered by Bohelski. Bohelski gets lost it on the play. Recovered by Elk River. There to add his support was Caleb Scheckert. He lost the puck. And Weston Olsen now battling. Centering pass over to Bohelski. He's going to wind up. Saved by the Elk River goalie. Nobody there for Moorhead to get a rebound. Pass from the point now by Cole Salvold. Weston Olsen gets pushed down from behind over the goaltender's stick by an Elk River player. Another loose puck now by Weston Olsen. He was trying to hit Caleb Scheckert. Scheckert sends the puck back to Herman. Herman, unable to get a clear shot, sends it over to Caleb Scheckert. Scheckert trying to tee up a sniper of a pass right into the skate of an Elk River player. Cole Salvold now trying to hit DDD. Loses that puck and wasn't able to get anything on it. Elk River trying to give the puck out to center ice to see if there could have been a breakaway attempt there by one of their players. Another centering pass by Elk River, just out of the reach of multiple players. Recovered by Cole Salvold. He sends it across to Anna Herman. Herman passes the puck up to Weston Olsen. He's going to charge forward and carry the puck down into the Elk River zone. Weston Olsen centering pass right into the back knee of an Elk River player. Recovered by Elk River now. There he puts on the brakes multiple times, changes directions, and he dumps the puck up along the board. Saved and kept in the zone by Cole Salvold. Great effort by Salvold to get over there and stop that bouncing puck out of the air. Very hard to do is to track the direction that these pucks are going. Elk River now doing another line change. Moorhead's going to have to be very careful as Elk River is being very strategic in their line changes, having their player box in the defensive zone of Moorhead. Loose puck now, once again. Tried to get cleared by another Moorhead player, Cole Salvevold, as the puck pop up off of Salvevold's stick and up over Dylan Elliott. Another unfortunate goal against Moorhead. Puck luck definitely not in Moorhead's favor this afternoon. No doubt definitely getting on the nerves of Dylan Elliott. He taps his post, trying to clear his head. Couple bad bounces, not going in Moorhead's way, finds Moorhead in a 5-0 deficit against Elk River. Puck now carried by Brady Mickelson. He does a nice stick move. He trips over snow in front of the blue line there and lost an edge. Elk River charging forward. That puck gets nicely blocked off there by Ethan Bjorkman. Bjorkman charges up. It's recovered now by Donovan Lewin, who's going to carry it down into the Elk River zone. He has the puck stripped off of his stick by an Elk River player. Tried to backhand it to the center of the net where Wyatt Olson was waiting. Too many Elk River players there. Knocked the puck out of the way. Recovered by Elk River and dumped up along the boards now. Tried to get kept. It successfully was kept into the zone initially by Brady Mickelson. Elk River now finally successfully able to get it out of their zone. Recovered by Mickey, who sent it across to Bjorkman, who dumped it down again once into the Elk River zone. Wyatt Olson now goes in, charging. Wyatt Olson's going to get called on an extremely weak penalty now. That's a terrible call, in my opinion. Refs are starting to get a little bit whistle-happy in this game, and they're going to have to get that under control if we want this game to end anytime before 8 o'clock this evening. Brings the draw now all the way down into the Moorhead net, right in front of our very own Dylan Elliott. Another penalty kill for Moorhead, finding them on a 5-4 one-man disadvantage. Moorhead definitely not doing well, trying their luck on these penalty kills. We'll see if they can get away with another one. Face-off won by Elk River, brought back to their defense. That shot goes definitely far wide of the Moorhead net. Anna Herman now charging in on the corner, tries to recover the puck. Recovered now by Elk River, sends it out to their defense. Brady Elliott, he was doing a nice save there by Dylan Elliott. That shot was from the point. Elliott, able to get enough blocker on it, knocks it wide. Kept in the zone there nicely by the Elk River defense. Recovered now by Cole Salvevold. Salvevold picks his head up, sees Reese Oswald wide open. Oswald taking time now in center ice. He's going to put on the brakes down in Elk River zone. Continuing with the puck, finally has the puck knocked off. Unable to do anything with it. Just, I don't know what he was trying to do, but it wasn't much of anything. Elk River there coming down in. Another loose puck right in front, right into the brisket. And Moorhead, tons of players just standing there right in front. Let's Elk River wind up. Lots of rebounds that are being offered. Moorhead looks like they're completely falling apart, and it's disheartening to see. After playing so well this morning, Moorhead's going to have to figure out how to calm themselves down, how to get their heads back in their shoulder if they want to have this game not be running time in the third, which unfortunately looks like that's going to be the case if this keeps moving forward in this manner. Faceoff now won by Elk River. And possession controlled by Elk River brings the puck down into the Moorhead zone. Puck wrapped around the Moorhead net. Reaching for the puck there was Brady Mickelson. Recovered now, given chase by Landon Gerskis. Gerskis is able to pop the puck up where it's recovered by Mason Mahelski. Mahelski's intended target, Caleb Schockert, easily picked off there by Elk River as their defense came in and read that play like a book. They're going to continue carrying the puck now behind the Moorhead net. Covered now by Brady Mickelson. We'll see if this can happen again. Another pass from Mickelson out to the center ice, right to the stick of an Elk River player. Elk River changes direction once again, brings it down into the Moorhead zone. Dylan Elliott way wide out of net and stayed out of net as he was trying to, I don't know, he thought that it was out. Dylan Elliott's head definitely starting to not be in this game at all. As the puck bounced around the boards on the backside of the net where Elk River was easily able to grab it and send it out front to where they had a waiting player and sent it into a completely unoccupied net. 7-0 the score now, Moorhead trailing Elk River. 3 minutes and 15 seconds left in the second period. Lots of game for Moorhead to turn things around and try and come back. Lots of game for Elk River to double this score if Moorhead keeps playing this way. Elk River, rather, now having possession, dumps the puck up along the boards. Picked up now by Anna Herman. She's going to put on the brakes in the near side corner. Put on the brakes again, change direction, trying to figure out what to do. Lots of standing around by Moorhead. Herman trying to do everything. She gets taken off on the play. She's going to have to continue with the puck. Centering pass there, right to where Caleb Schuckert was standing and waiting. He has the puck stripped off of his, or knocked off of his stick, rather, very easily by Elk River defense. Schuckert taken down on the play, away from it, from an Elk River player. Elk River now carrying the puck back into the Moorhead zone. Anna Herman doing what she can to try and knock the puck off. She successfully does so and carries the puck. She sends the puck up along the boards to Cole Salvold. Salvold backhand passes it up to Mohelski. Mohelski passes the puck behind Caleb Schuckert, unable to get the puck anywhere. Moorhead not doing anything that resembles any type of play that we've had any type of practice of. Sending the puck to where nobody's at. They got to start getting control of this game, otherwise it's going to get extremely ugly, more so than it already is. Elk River toying with Moorhead now, passing the puck back and forth with their defense. Elk River regains control of the puck. Battle along the far boards between Salvold, Schuckert, and Olsen. Schuckert now carrying the puck out, has the puck bounce off, and he's able to recover it here in the neutral area. He lost control of the puck. Schuckert, he gets taken down into the play as he dove after stomping into one of the Elk River. He took offense to that, came up and gave the kid a nice little shove. Lucky we didn't get called a retaliation penalty on that. Elk River now gets a shot off. Elliott able to drop down, puts on the brakes to that puck. Schuckert taking offense to a different player than what he was having in. He's going to have to keep his head on his shoulders and not lose his temper, otherwise he's going to find himself in the penalty box, giving Moorhead another penalty kill, which would put him at another disadvantage that Elk River has proven they are very capable of capitalizing on. Faceoff now for Moorhead. Wyatt Olsen taking the draw. Possession controlled by Elk River. Shot from the point there, saved by Dylan Elliott. Carried now into the corner and passed up front by Bodie Ferry to Wyatt Olsen. Wyatt Olsen keeps possession of the puck. He is the puck stripped off of his stick, but sent right into Brady Mickelson. Wyatt Olsen reaching for the puck to try and get it. That Elk River player able to get something on it and recover it. Puck being chased now, recovered by Ethan Bjorkman deep down in the Moorhead zone. Bjorkman has the Elk River player immediately on it. Bjorkman sending another pass to absolutely nowhere in center ice, right into the stick of a waiting Elk River player. Wyatt Olsen now looking for a penalty on the call on that, as he was racing for the puck, got taken down. Bodie Ferry, a really hard centering pass right to where nobody was at, picked up now in neutral area again by Ethan Bjorkman. Bjorkman sends the puck across to Brady Mickelson. Mickelson sends the puck right back to Bjorkman. Bjorkman sends the puck to Donovan Lewin, who didn't have his stick down on the ice at all and didn't even look like he attempted to try and save that pass. It allowed it right to go to Elk River, and Elk River recovering the puck. They're going to dump the puck back here in the center ice. Again, Mickey grabbing the puck and passing it up to Bodie Ferry. Ferry's going to flip the puck over everybody here, and it bounces down. Recovered by Elk River down in their zone. They put on the brakes, and that's going to bring finally an end to a second period, which was just very destructive to this Moorhead team. Moorhead is going to have to take any amount of time that they're given here between periods to try and calm themselves down, try and get their emotion out of their heads, get their wits back together, and start playing hockey again, because what they're playing right now, be quite honest, is extremely far from hockey. Gerskis, if you're logged in and you're watching, please have a drink for me after this one, would you, bud? Thank you. Here we go. Start of the third period. 15 minutes left for Moorhead to try and figure out anything what to do. It's going to be running time. Faceoff was won by Moorhead, recovered by Elk River. Shot on net there, but blocker saved by Dylan Elliott. Another centering pass there to a wide open Elk River player who was completely unguarded. He sends that lunar of a pass high up over the Moorhead net, luckily for Dylan Elliott. Shot from the point there, redirected but recovered by Elk River, sends it out to their D-man. Nice leg save there by Dylan Elliott. Allows that puck to get brought out, finally out into the neutral area where Brody Elliott was able to bring it in. Recovered now by Landon Gerskis, who actually quite nicely took a second to pause, recognized that the goalie was down, tried flipping it up over the goalie, just sent it a little bit too high. It would have been a fantastic play there by Gerskis, keeping calm and recognizing what it was. Gerskis again trying to do a centering pass from behind, or from in the corner rather, recovered by Elk River and brought behind their net. Brody Elliott, he's going to come in, he does a nice job of rubbing the player off the puck along the boards there. Shot by Reese Oswald there, sends the puck just wide of the Elk River net, recovered along the far boards by Landon Gerskis, who dumps it in behind Elk River. It's going to get both teams the time to kind of get situated. Moorhead giving Elk River all the time in the world that they want to get regrouped. Puck finds its way out here now to Cole Salvold. Salvold running into Caleb Schockert, who wanted to get in the way. And a big collision there with Cole Salvold and an Elk River player who both were watching the play, and unfortunately they both kind of collided with each other. No calls on that play. Both players definitely feeling it though. Pardon the break, had to get a drink there. My voice was starting to go. Face off now after the Elk River charged forward on it. Found its way down to the Moorhead zone. Tipped up by Mason Mahalski, where he found Caleb Schockert. Schockert now coming in. Schockert getting in there, and a goal now, finally from Moorhead. Brady Mickelson in the right place at the right time with a stick down, finds that rebound that got shot from Schockert's shot from the very wide angle. And Mickelson able to capitalize it and just change the direction of the puck and slap it right underneath the Elk River goaltender. Finally gets Moorhead on the board. Still trailing by 6. Running time continues here in the third period. Looks like 12 minutes and 15 seconds of running time right now at this moment. Moorhead trailing 7-1. Shot from the point. That went up. Got deflected high. It's going to be a high sticking. Nope, get called off now. It was a high sticking that would have been called on Elk River because the puck was up so high and it had been tipped. But since Moorhead touched the puck before Elk River, play was allowed to resume on. Battle rages on now as Weston Olsen found himself getting smashed up into the boards. And now Elk River is going to dump the puck along the boards. And they've got a two-on-one opportunity. A centering pass hits the stick of Ethan Bjorkman, making it bounce up out of unable to make it. And there you just saw not much Dylan Elliott could have done on that. A pass from the point. The perfect kind of shot from the point that was bouncing right on the ground was able to get changed direction ever so slightly and just out of the leg side reach of Dylan Elliott. Another one on the board, 8-1. Elk River up over Moorhead. Elk River winning the draw and sends it back to their defense, who dump it up to their forward. Recovered now and chipped back up right through the middle of traffic by Colt Salvold, where Elk River easily dumps it back down to the Moorhead zone. Picked up in the near corner by Cole Sell. He puts on the brakes, changes direction. He's going to pass it up, trying to hit intend to target Wyatt Olson. Picked off there by Elk River, unable to keep possession. Allows Bodie Ferry to carry the puck in. Wyatt Olson trying to get a shot off. He gets taken down on the play, and Elk River charges forward. Anna Herman trying to do a poke check on that player. He lost the puck. Nice attempt there by Elk River to try and dump the puck across. Had their their F3 player. Penalty is going to be called now on Elk River, as there was going to be a hooking call on that play as Moorhead was trying to come down and enter into the Elk River zone. Time still ticking away. 10 minutes and 15 seconds. Score 8-1. Elk River up by 7 over Moorhead. Moorhead definitely flustered looking like a completely different team than they did in the previous two games, finds themselves again in the one-man advantage on a power play. Hopefully they'll be able to pop one in. Face off there, won and controlled by Brody Elliott. Loose puck gets picked up there by Elk River. Elk River charging forward, puts on and changes direction. That shot, high shot, right into the butterfly leg save of Dylan Elliott. Pass out to Brody Elliott, the brother of Dylan Elliott, right in onto his stick. Recovered, now right at the blue line. Reaching for it was Landon Gerskis to try and keep it in. That puck runs into a snag as it crashed into the shin pads of the referee trying to jump out of the way. Pass from Ethan Bjorkman to Brody Elliott. His puck, or his shot, was going to be going wide. Glove saved and held on by the Elk River goaltender. Brings a stoppage of play with time still ticking. Face-off there, won by Elk River. Brody Elliott looking like he extended out a folded five and knocked that Elk River player, immediately turning and looking at the ref to see if he had been noticed, wondering if he was going to get called for a penalty. Landon Gerskis battling for the puck behind the Elk River net now. He lost possession of it as he was getting teamed up by three Elk River players to one. Reese Oswald doing a fine job of keeping it into the zone there and knocking it off. He's going to dump it down along into the corner. Elk River recovers, puts on the brakes behind their own net. Brody Elliott giving chase. He's going to drop down like a cold meat salami. He smashes himself up into the boards. Reese Oswald charging forward, knocks the stick out of that Elk River player's hands. Loose puck now recovered by Elk River along the boards near underside the camera here. Shot from the point, right into the leg pad of Dylan Elliott, who deflects it wide. Covered now by Brady Mickelson. He's going to continue charging on. Landon Gerskis now regains control for Moorhead. He's going to come racing down. He's going to get taken out on the play and has the puck stripped off. Penalty now going to be called against Gerskis, as when he was there, he got his stick tied up right into the toque, I think, of the Elk River player, which caused the player to trip down. An unfortunate location for Gerskis' stick, as I don't think that that was intentional. Just one of those freak things that his stick got tied up in the skates and pulled the kid down as Gerskis went down. So that's going to send him to the box for a minute and a half. Going to give Moorhead another penalty kill. When I go back and review this tape, I think I'm going to look at how much time they spent in each period with a one-man disadvantage or even a two-man disadvantage, because they've been in the penalty box just about as much time as they haven't, and that's been unfortunate. Moorhead's going to have to clean that up. Face-off now against Mason Mihelski, won by Elk River. Brought out of the zone as Caleb Schuckert was battling that puck and was able to force the possession out. Dumped back into the Moorhead zone, recovered by Cole Salvold in the near side corner. He gets taken off on the play. He's upset as he got tied up by the Elk River player who was holding on to his leg and not allowing him to go. Elk River now trying to send it D-to-D. He's going to be recovered by Caleb Schuckert. He has the puck poked off of his stick quite beautifully, got to be honest, by that Elk River player. Fantastic job. Penalty now going to be called on Moorhead on Cole Salvold for hooking as he got his stick a little bit too high. Sends the second Moorhead player into the box. Time still ticking, 6 minutes and 27 seconds left in the third period. Moorhead down 8-1 against Elk River, finding themselves in a disappointing situation. Shot there, nice save by Dylan Elliott from Elk River from out in front. 5-3, two-man disadvantage now. Elk River able to find one of their players who had... It almost looked like there was a player that was covering them, and a shot was still able to get taken off under the leg pad of Dylan Elliott. Chalks another one up on the board for Elk River, 9-1 now the score. Moorhead going to have to do everything they can try and keep Elk River out of getting double digits. At least they can hold on to that. Elk River wins the draw, carries it forward, passes back now to their defense, and their defense is going to dump it down into the near side corner. He's tied up on the play by Ethan Bjorkman. Bjorkman unaware of where the puck is. Lets off and allows the second Elk River player to come in. Mohelski now recognizing he's going to go in and try and do what he can to get the puck out. Elk River coming out of the corner there with the puck and finding an unguarded Elk River player right behind Brady Mickelson, who was able to find that loose puck while Mickelson had no idea where it was, and just very slightly taps the puck in. Another one think I spoke too soon about the double digits. I don't want to say that I jinxed the team because I don't think I've had anything to do with the unfortunate mishappenings that Moorhead has been putting on themselves this afternoon in this terrible hockey game. Faceoff there won by Bodie Ferry. Possession immediately regained by Elk River. They're going to come charging in. They skated around a couple players. That puck now finds its way in, slapped out of the way by Ethan Bjorkman right to the stick of an Elk River defense player. Wyatt Olson, surprised he's not going to get called on that as his stick got underneath an Elk River player, sending him down to the ice. Bodie Ferry waiting for that puck, gets an Elk River player beating him to it. Nice little jab there by Ethan Bjorkman as he gets thrown up into the boards. He went into the boards hard and fell like a tree. That's going to send Elk River. And they need to stop time. Stop time! Clock! Even when there's running time, you stop the clock, and the time was still ticking away. First thing that I noticed was to turn and look at that when I knew that Bjorkman's down. He's still down. He's going to remain down hard. It brings out coaching staff and the on-site emergency personnel, as Bjorkman obviously hit the boards hard there in that play. Almost looked like he didn't do a whole lot to try and catch himself either, and that's when it becomes scary. Bjorkman now sitting up, being tended to by the on-site security personnel. Or safe healthcare personnel, rather, not security. Moving around, being helped up to his feet now. He gets up, gets brushed off. He's going to make his way to his bench. Play will resume now, down in the Moorhead end. Wyatt Olson lining up to take the faceoff against Elk River. Moorhead getting called on a penalty also for something. I can't tell who that is that's down there in the box. For Moorhead, Mitt. Might be Bodie Ferry. I'm not exactly sure. I don't know what he did on that play to get called. Maybe it was something that was after it. I'll have to find out in the official scorebook. Anna Herman now carrying the puck for Moorhead behind the net. Recovered along the boards here by Donovan Lewin. He chips it up to Reese Oswald. Oswald hits something. Lost an edge there. Unable to keep possession of the puck. Loose puck there by Elk River. Capitalized upon by Wyatt Olson. Grabs the loose puck. Wyatt Olson able to do a quick rappy and send the puck underneath the leg pads of the Elk River goalie. Might be a little too late though for this Moorhead team. Wyatt Olson with the goal exits the ice, still looking really sluggish and disappointed in how his team's been performing. Elk River coming out strong after Moorhead wins the draw, charge forward and gets a nice hard shot right towards the Moorhead net. Covered now along the far boards by Landon Gerskis, only to have Elk River dump the puck back down into the Moorhead zone. Picked up in the far corner by Brady Mickelson. Now he's going to carry the puck around the net. He's going to try and continue skating it instead of passing it up. Finally, he's going to pass it up behind the stick of Landon Gerskis through the skates, where Elk River is able to easily grab it and send it across. Mickelson sends it over to Ethan Bjorkman. Glad to see he's back out on the ice this soon. Loose puck now picked up by Reese Oswald. Oswald's going to come skating in. He loses possession of the puck because he was trying to tee up. A Moorhead player comes charging in, and he went down hard into the boards. That was Brody Elliott. He looked like he crashed headfirst into the board. He's up. He's moving around. You'll see him. He's calling for the puck behind the scenes. He's going to charge forward as Ethan Bjorkman wasn't able to get enough on the puck to get the puck over to him. Elk River dumps the puck back down into the Moorhead zone. Carried behind their own net is Brady Mickelson. Mickelson just Featherly passes the puck up. Very little effort now, as it looks like some of these players are looking like they're just kind of shutting down in their effort level. Battle along the boards there. Picked up now by Mickelson. He tried toe-dragging it, has the puck tipped off. Recovered by Reese Oswald, who sent it back to where Ethan Bjorkman was asking for the pass, but then unable to receive the pass that was sent as he was asking for it. Bjorkman recovers his missed pass, tries hitting intended target Caleb Schuckert right into the stick again of another poorly located pass to Elk River. Schuckert receiving a puck there in front of the Elk River net, unable to keep possession on his stick. Elk River now charging forward once again, dumps the puck down behind the Moorhead net. 1 minute and 10 seconds left in the game. Covered by Anna Herman, she sends it up to Brody Elliott. Elliott now is going to come charging in. He has the puck poke checked off of his stick. Herman grabbing the puck, sends it down close by the Elk River net, recovered by Elk River, right into the leg pads of Caleb Schuckert. Schuckert now, he's going to try and instead of skating up to the puck, just reach forward and try and tip the puck in towards center ice. Unable to find anything with it. Mason Wachelski recovers the puck now. He's going to carry the puck in. Nice centering pass attempt there, saved by an Elk River defense. Recovered by Caleb Schuckert, who was trying to pass the puck all the way across to the far side defense here. Cole Salvevold. Schuckert's pass right into the pads of an Elk River player. Salvevold now trying to recover the puck back here in the neutral area, lost control of it. Elk River now regaining control. They're going to dump the puck back down in. 13 seconds left in the game. Anna Herman now is going to have one last final drive. She's going to pass it up to Weston Olson. Weston Olson loses the puck and wasn't able to keep anything on it. Hard shot by Elk River over and hits the pipe, and that's going to bring the conclusion to this absolutely horrendous game that Moorhead's going to have to completely forget about as they re-gear up to take on somebody tomorrow. I don't exactly know who, but no doubt will not be the championship game. Most likely will be the third place game, whatever time that's at, and whoever they'll tee up to have to play against. Regardless, this game's going to have to get put behind us. We're going to have to learn from it, figure out the mistakes that we were making. Because from here on out, we're only going to be playing good teams like the Silk River team. It's going to be challenging, and it's going to be a long, hard, cold season if we keep dismantling ourselves the way that you just witnessed this afternoon. Very unfortunate set of events for this Moorhead team. Thanks, everybody, for watching in. I wish it would have been a better broadcast for you to be able to watch and cheer on. Enjoy the rest of your Saturday afternoon, and we'll catch you again here tomorrow.